to learn the good, the bad, and the reality of the nomadic lifestyle, click the subscribe button so you don't miss anything. Click the bell notification. Look at this. Grass and trees. I mean, like real trees, like they have in Missouri. I mean, you know, look at that. Trees. I'm in a city park in Mideast. I'm on the east border by Texas, New Mexico. So I'm right there next to Texas. I'm kind of like just mid New Mexico. Not all of New Mexico is desert or mountainous. Much of it looks much like Missouri. So it's good to get back to having grass underneath my feet and some trees and some shade. It's just real nice. To realize how homesick you were when you were out in the desert. The closest thing I had a memory of home was in New Mexico. There was a cedar tree in our campground, and it reminded me of Christmas at home when Dad would cut down a cedar tree for Christmas. There's something to say about being back into your home environment. I remember when I was in the Navy, I was up in Seattle, Washington. Seattle, Washington was absolutely beautiful, just like Arizona and New Mexico and Utah. It's just breathtakingly beautiful. I was there for 4 years when I wasn't on a boat. I guess you could say I was there 2.5 years because I was underway for 6 months of a year. In Seattle area, it doesn't have a lot of seasons. It's pretty much just rain all year round. Cold rain, warmer rain, just it rains a lot. When I first time I came home on leave, there was snow, and I really enjoyed the snow. I mean, it was like, wow, snow. I've forgotten what snow was like. Snow. Of course, you could go up in the mountains in Washington and go to snow, but just to go walk out your back door and have snow, it was really nice. Well, the longer I was in Seattle, the more I felt like I was missing something. And the best way I could explain it was, it was all concrete up there. And when I got home, there was grass. But I didn't realize what it is I was missing until I actually got out of the Navy and went back to Missouri. And it was the seasons. I missed the seasons. It was just always springtime in Washington. That rainy, gloomy springtime all year round. I've experienced this kind of feeling several times in my life. When we went to, as a nomad, we went into the West Virginia Smoky Mountain Range in the Thomas Jefferson National Forest and the George Washington National Forest. And the whole summer, it was in the 50s at the tops. I mean, I think there was a couple times it got up into the 70s, but most of the time it was in the 50s and cold and rainy, and a low humidity. I don't feel like there was a lot of humidity, even though it rained a lot. Well, when we came out of the mountains, we ended up stopping in South Carolina, and it was, I think, 80 degrees and humid. It just felt right. It felt like home. It just felt like it was supposed to be summertime. I didn't realize how much I was missing it until I was actually there. But I will tell you that when you're in these locations, you do start to sense this craving for something. So for 2 years, you know, a lot of people have been telling me that I need to go to the West. I need to go to Arizona and New Mexico and Nevada and Utah and all those areas. It was strongly encouraged that if you're going to be a nomad, you got to go there. And I've even heard people say the West is the best. I mean, I understood that the beauty was there. I really understood that. That there was a lot of pretty things to see that you don't get to see on the East. Don't get me wrong. I think the things in the East are absolutely beautiful. But if you're from the East, maybe you get tired of them. Maybe you're looking to see something. For some reason, I just didn't feel this driving urge to go out west. I just didn't have it like a lot of nomads seem to have. Yeah, I was kind of looking forward to seeing the Grand Canyon. Actually, seeing the Grand Canyon was a lifelong dream, but you know, that is a vacation. Not so much something I wanted to go live to do. And boy, did I have a great time at the Grand Canyon. I really enjoyed it. But I don't know if I want to stay there all the time. Then we went to Utah, we went into the desert. And again, very beautiful. We were just outside the Zion National Park. Very beautiful. But it was always, of course, it was hot, but that's beside the point. Heat don't bother me. But it was very dry and dusty. And you miss the grass. I mean, don't get me wrong, they got cactus there. And I suppose if you're from Utah and you're used to the cactus and you're used to that dryness, It feels comfortable to you, but the grass feels comfortable to me. And then we went to the Red Cliff in Utah. And again, boy, I had an excellent time, but it was a vacation excellent time. I climbed the rocks, the Red Cliffs. I climbed those daily. And I tried to take you up on the cliffs with me the entire time. And it was wonderful. I had a great time. But I felt out of place. I just didn't feel like it was where I wanted to be. And then we went to the Coconino National Forest. And you know, Carolyn and I did discuss it a lot, how we really felt kind of back at home. Although I now know that I didn't feel quite as at home there as I do here, and I'll explain in a minute. The trees, we had huge tall trees again, we had shade, the temperature was pleasant, and it just felt nice. There was rain, we had some rain, a little bit of rain, not a lot, but a little bit of rain, and it felt like a little bit like home. Well, then we went back to New Mexico, and it was mostly desert again. And like I said, New Mexico, you know, there's this cedar tree, and it gave you that flashback of home at Christmas time with the cedar tree. But then we got here, and as soon as I got out of the truck, I felt like home. You hear that noise? The cicadas? When I was a kid, they were called locusts. And I remember the first time I really heard the locusts, I don't know, I was probably in eighth grade, and the 17-year locust came out. They were everywhere. I mean, they make holes in the ground. And this is a memory. This noise is a memory. And that's the first thing I heard when I got out of the truck was I heard the cicadas. But the second thing I felt was freshly mowed grass. The smell was just overwhelming. It was like, wow. It was just beautiful. And then the third thing I felt was the humidity. It is quite humid here. 70-80% humidity. It just feels like a blanket, like something like home. And then that night it stormed. Lightning in the distance, rain hitting the roof, flash flood warnings, all those things coming back on the apps that we've missed for 3 months. I've missed the thunderstorms. Be aware that you may get homesick when you become a van life nomad. Thanks for watching. Click like if you like video, and happy travels.